Welcome to the fourth video in our clone series, where we will look at how to use the destroy block. This video is a bit more advanced. Make sure that you've watched the first three videos in our clone series before starting this video. While you're watching this video, I'll give you time to pause and follow along. Feel free to rewind whenever you need. You can also pinch two fingers on this video to resize it. And feel free to turn on closed captions. You can play the project to test it out. In our Space Invaders project, we have a lot of enemies, but the player can only shoot one projectile at a time. It makes it difficult to shoot enough projectiles fast enough to take the enemies on. Let's give our player the ability to shoot multiple projectiles at once. This video consists of two main parts. Part 1 is where we look at an overview of how the destroy block behaves, and part 2 is where we add code for multiple projectiles in our Space Invaders game. Part 1, overview of the destroy block. This part is a demonstration, so you don't need to code along here yet. You can pinch on the video to make it bigger and watch along. The destroy block will delete an object. I'll add it to an object to demonstrate. I'll add a when iPad is tapped rule and add a destroy block. Now I'll play the project. When I tap my iPad, Chelana disappears. A destroyed object will no longer exist in the game and will no longer run any code. Destroy block and clones. If a clone destroys itself, it will no longer exist as well, and it will destroy itself and not other clones. Like code for clones in general, it will run the code only if the rule applies for itself. For example, I can make a bunch of clones spawn around the screen. Let's see what happens if I add a rule for when self is tapped and add a destroy block here. Now, when I tap an individual clone, it will destroy itself. When I tap on the clone, it will destroy the clone being tapped instead of all the clones that were created on the screen. The destroy block is handy for deleting objects that don't need to be used anymore. For example, with the projectile, it doesn't need to be used anymore after it has been fired. Projects can get laggy with a huge number of clones because it means that there are a lot of objects to update. So it's useful to be able to destroy objects that you don't need anymore so that there are less objects to update. Now that we have an overview of how the destroy block works, let's look at how to let our player shoot multiple projectiles at once. Part 2. Shooting multiple projectiles. Let's get started with coding. You can pinch on the video to make it smaller again so that you can see your code. So at the moment, the projectile goes to the position of my player and then moves up the screen. How can we have the player fire multiple projectiles at once? One option would be to add multiple projectile objects with the same code. This would require us to drag out new objects and then basically repeat the code several times for every object. Or instead, we could make the projectile object clone itself whenever the player wants to shoot. When my player shoots, each projectile will go to where my player is and move upwards in turn. If you're in play mode for the Space Invaders project, you can tap the arrow in the top left corner of the screen to go back into edit mode. Let's go to the code of the projectile object. This is the red circle object above the player. Tap the projectile object. Check that the object has the name player projectile. Then tap C code. It seems that this object responds to the shoot button pressed message. Instead of the original projectile moving itself up each time the player fires, let's make the original object clone itself, and then each clone will move itself up when fired. Each clone will listen in to the message that's broadcast when the shoot button is pressed. Then, it will go to the position of the player and move up. So let's make the object clone itself first. Tap inside the rule that says, "When I get a message, shoot button pressed." Make sure that you tap in the blank space above the player projectile ability and not on the when container. And tap the blue control section of the block's keyboard. Then, tap the create a clone block to add it to your code. Now let's change the player projectile ability to be in a when object is cloned rule so that only the clones will run this. Each projectile only needs to set its appearance and move up when it is cloned. Tap underneath the When I Get a Message rule to add a new rule. Make sure that you've tapped in the blank space in between the rules and not on the rules themselves. Then, scroll right to find the When Object is Cloned rule and tap that. Now let's drag the player projectile ability inside. You can press and hold on the handle of the block to drag it, which is the part with three horizontal lines. Pause here to add the code to your own project. Let's see what happens. Tap the play button in the top right corner of the screen. Okay, now we're in play mode. Try pressing the shoot button. This creates projectile clones very quickly. And it looks like our project sometimes freezes and is really laggy because there are so many objects to update. The projectiles also stay stuck at the top of the screen. If the project gets too laggy and freezes, you can exit the project and come back. Your progress will be saved and you can continue from where you left off. You can see that we have an object to count how many projectiles there are. It uses the total clones variable, which tells us the total number of an object that has been created, including the clones and the original object. There are a lot of clones being created. Let's go back into edit mode. Tap the arrow in the top left corner of the screen to go back into edit mode. Let's address the number of projectile clones being stuck at the top of the screen first. We want them to be destroyed after being fired since they're not being used anymore. This will make them disappear. And since our project doesn't have to update their code anymore, it won't be so laggy. Go to the When Object is Cloned rule with the player projectile ability. To add the destroy block, tap in the space underneath the ability. Then, tap the blue control section of the keyboard and tap the destroy block. The destroy block removes the clone so that it doesn't exist anymore. The object will no longer run any code or appear on the screen once it has been destroyed. Let's play the project and see what happens. Tap the play button in the top right corner of the screen. Okay, the clones are being destroyed now, after they have moved up the screen. The project is still pretty laggy though. It seems like a huge number of clones are still being created very quickly. Let's go back into edit mode and address the rapid firing rate next. Tap the arrow in the top left corner to go back into edit mode. Let's go through the code more closely. So we have this create a clone block under the rule that says, when I get a message, shoot button pressed. Oh, it looks like all the other clones are responding to this message at once. So we might just make the original object the one that creates the clones. To do this, let's use clone index. The word index relates to order, and clone index refers to the order in which the clone was created. It starts from 0. So the original object will have a clone index of 0, the first object that is cloned will have a clone index of 1, the second object that is cloned will have a clone index of 2, and so on. Let's make the object check whether its clone index is 0, which will mean that it is the original object. Tap in the blank space above the Create a Clone block, and under the Control section of the block's keyboard, tap the Check Once If block. Tap equals. We can find the clone index under Object Variables, so tap the Objects tab at the bottom. Then, tap the clone index variable. For the second bubble, type in 0 and then tap Done. Now let's drag the Create a Clone block inside it. Press on the handle of the Create a Clone block to drag it. Pause here to add the code to your own project. Now let's play the project to test that change. Tap the play button in the top right corner of the screen. Yeah. Our project is no longer so laggy, since only the original object is creating clones. Wow, the rate is still very quick. It looks like I can just hold down the shoot button and obliterate all the enemies. Whoosh! This makes the game a little too easy. Let's go back into edit mode. Tap the arrow in the top left corner of the screen to go back into edit mode. Let's try adding some wait time in between each new clone to slow the rate at which the projectiles are being created. We can use the wait block to add some delay to our code. This block waits for a certain amount of time that you specify before running the next block of code. In the rule that says, when I get a message, shoot button pressed, tap in the blank space beneath the create a clone block. Then tap the wait block to add that. Let's try setting it to 0.2 seconds for now. Type in 0.2. As always, feel free to adjust these values to find a suitable difficulty for your game. Let's press play and see how that turns out. Nice work. The projectiles are firing at a controllable pace and are destroying themselves after they have been fired. Let's also make the projectiles destroy themselves after hitting an enemy. It would be a pretty unrealistically strong projectile that can penetrate through multiple enemies. It also adds challenge to the game if the projectile destroys itself after hitting an enemy as well. So let's tap the arrow in the top left corner of the screen to go back into edit mode. Let's add a new rule. Tap in the blank space below the last when container. Tap the collisions tab and then select bumps. It has filled in self for us in the first slot, and let's choose the enemy in the second slot. The bumps rule will run when our projectile bumps any of the enemy objects, including the clones. Then we will add the code for destroying the projectile when it bumps the enemy. Tap the controls tab and then tap the destroy block to add that into your code. Now our projectiles should destroy themselves when they bump into an enemy. Let's press play to see how it turned out. Tap the play button in the top right corner of the screen. Try shooting at some enemies. Great! Now our projectiles destroy themselves after hitting an enemy too. Nice work! Now we have a Space Invaders game with many enemies and multiple projectiles, thanks to the use of clones. You can try customizing the project as you like. We hope you've learned some handy tips for using clones, and we can't wait to see all the cool projects that you make with them in the future. Happy hopscotching!